Hello and welcome. You're watching CNN News 18 and I'm Poonam Burde. Our non-stop coverage here on verdict day for Maharashtra and Jharkhand continues. Maharashtra is the state where 288 seats are at stake. It's the second highest Lok Sabha sending state, which is why it's extremely important. It's also important because the NDA has stormed back to power. The numbers are on your screens. You can see what the victory for the NDA looks like. It is at last count, and counting is still on. At last count, 219 leads is what the NDA has. Several of them are wins, but several of them, the counting is still underway. But that hasn't stopped celebrations that have erupted in different parts of Maharashtra. Eknath Shinde, the incumbent chief minister, has dedicated this victory specifically to the women of the state. The Ladki Bahin scheme has worked wonders, is what the NDA believes, which is why this heartfelt special appreciation and thanks coming in from the incumbent to the women voters of the state. He also took on the MVA, saying that these Ladki Bahins have voted NDA to victory and they finally know which is the real Sena. The Mahayuti camp, which is the NDA, is in a huddle now. BJP central observers are going to be in Maharashtra tomorrow in Mumbai. BJP, of course, rooting for Devendra Fadnavis to be the chief minister, and the numbers are on their side for it. Eknath Shinde, too, going on to say that those who have the highest numbers will have the chief minister's chair. Does that mean he's ready to give it up to a BJP leader, perhaps Fadnavis, who is the front runner at the moment? The Mahavikas Agadi Alliance, on the other hand, has managed to gain leads in 65 seats. They've clearly lost their comeback hope. The momentum that they had in the Lok Sabha elections, they haven't been able to convert that at all as far as Vidhan Sabha elections are concerned. Uddhav Thackeray, Sharad Pawar, perhaps the worst performing in their career, if you look at the results on your screens. 14 for the NCP Sharad Pawar faction, 27 for the UBT Sena. For Sharad Pawar specifically, this is his worst performance in his entire career. What this means for the NCP SP, for the Uddhav Thackeray Sena, will they see more defections now to the other camp? That's something that they have to look at. But here's what the numbers look like, and that's what I want to tell you. It is the halfway mark in that 288 strong assembly. 145 was what was required. Most exit polls predicted that the BJP would have had a victory, but the margin would not have been a lot. But look at the numbers on your screens. At the last count, 221 for the NDA, 61 for the India camp. Like I said, 145 is the halfway mark. They're way past that halfway mark, way past majority. BJP, the single largest party with 132 seats, shy of the majority just themselves, and they have two other camps who've also pulled their weight. Both the Eknath Shinde faction, which is the Shiv Sena, and the NCP led by Sharad Pawar, led by Ajit Pawar.
सर आप ये मानते हैं कि लड़की बहना की जीत हुई है आज?
हो गया.
लड़की बहना की जीत हुई है सर.
लड़की बहन ने तो पूरा अंदाज सब फेल फेल कर दिया.
और आज फैसला हो गया कि असली शिवसेना कौन है?
वो भी हो गया, जनता के दरबार में हो गया.
थैंक यू सो मच.
जो नतीजे सामने आए उसके ऊपर मैं विश्वास रखने को तैयार नहीं. ये जनता का फैसला मानने को तैयार नहीं. हमने महाराष्ट्र की जनता का जो मन है हमें मालूम था किस दिशा में जा रहा है. ये जनता का कौल हो ही नहीं सकता. महाराष्ट्र की जनता का मन हमें मालूम है, ये हो ही नहीं सकता है. हमारी 4 या 5 सीटें लोगों ने चोरी की है, मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ.
Some Congress leaders are of course already blaming the EVM.
There is no denying that EVM debate has been sparked in this country. There is no denying that we must speak on the EVM. There is no denying that the Election Commission, because the elections were held late in Maharashtra, was advantaged the Mahayuti. But today I'm going to talk about the numbers on the screen, and the numbers on the screen are disappointing for us in Maharashtra, heartening for us in Jharkhand.
My colleagues have been getting us the mood and feel from on ground. Yasha is in Mumbai. Payal is at the Chief Minister's bungalow, which is Varsha, where Eknath Shinde spoke to her just a short while ago. Aman, my colleague, joining me from the Noida studio here. And let me bring in Aman first. Aman, as far as this election is concerned, the Mahavikas Agadi believe that they can keep the momentum from the Lok Sabha election and convert it to the Vidhan Sabha. They clearly misread the situation, isn't it?
Well, Poonam, a lot can change in 6 months. And, you know, a lot has changed in 6 months. 6 months ago, the dominant slogan in the Maharashtra Lok Sabha election was Samvidhan खतरे में है. दिस पर्टिकुलर इलेक्शन द डोमिनेंट स्लोगन इज ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी, एक है तो सेफ है. आई जस्ट ब्रेक इट डाउन इन 3 to 4 points आई थिंक विच हैव वर्क मैग्निफिसेंटली फॉर द महायुति इन महाराष्ट्र. नंबर वन, द वुमेन वोटर. 53 lakh more women voted in this election than the last election in Maharashtra in 2019, a 6% jump. And this woman voter seems to have completely backed the Mahayuti for the Ladki Behna scheme, a scheme in which they had already got money. And you know, whoever, my experience of women's schemes like these, whoever has the first mover advantage, whichever government gives this money first is always credited by the people. And we saw this in this particular election, such a high voter turnout of women, 6% up from the last election. Women, I think, transcending caste, religious barriers to vote for the Mahavikas Aghadi across the caste groups. I think that has been the biggest factor which has worked in this election. Number two, I think farmers, Poonam. The Vidarbh region farmers, you know, farmers is one community which was not happy with the Mahayuti in the last election because of the low prices of cotton, of soya bean. BJP turned the tables, promised this overtures to the cotton farmers, to the soya bean farmers at the end of the campaign in their manifesto. And more importantly, they promised a full loan waiver, something that the BJP usually does not do in a state election. I think this is something that has ringed the bell with the farmers. We see the big flip which has happened in the Vidarbh region. Third reason I would put the PM slogan, as I first said, Ek hai to safe hai, has united the OBC vote in the state like never before. 38% OBC vote, biggest chunk in the state. It seems to have totally consolidated for the BJP. The Hindu consolidation which has happened, I think, has done the trick, and that shows in the numbers. It's the first time an alliance has crossed 200 seats, first time an alliance has over 50% vote share. BJP itself at 130 seats. I think it is showing the magic which has been done. Of course, the Sharad Pawar's collapse has come as the icing on the cake for the BJP, because Sharad Pawar seems to have really pulled down the Mahavikas Aghadi and scoring is number 6 amongst the 6 parties. I think all these reasons together, along with the RSS push on the ground to the BJP, has helped them achieve this big milestone.
And like you said, the loan waiver promise, that's not something that the BJP has been in favor of all these years. For the last decade or so, many elections have come and gone by, but that's a promise that they haven't made up until now. Many saw that as a sign of desperation. Well, whether it was desperation or a well-conceived idea that helped them win this election, that would be disputed. But Yasha and Payal also continue to be with us. Now, Payal, the next question, of course, is going to be, who is going to be the chief minister? From the looks of it, even Eknath Shinde says or believes that the BJP should have the chief minister's chair because their numbers, the math is there for everyone to see, and that's not something he can fight.
Well, of course, it's a $1 million question. Let's not get into a word of the
action as we see outside the Eknath Shinde's residence outside Varsha Bungalow, and that's expected. We short while ago saw Eknath Shinde come out, as you see on your screens, the victory sign being waved by him and all of his members of parliament, all of his other leaders of the party. They have pulled their weight, and how, as far as this alliance goes. And speaking of pulling their weight, Ajit Pawar and his camp are someone who is believed to be the weak link as far as the NDA went. But he's too, in this occasion, proven that that's not the case. He's not dead weight and he can pull his weight through. This is redemption, perhaps, someone, isn't it, for the Ajit Pawar camp as well?
Well, absolutely. And the collapse of the Sharad Pawar faction in this particular election, I think, is a big leg up for Ajit Pawar. Now he can claim rightful legacy over the NCP, like Eknath Shinde is claiming over the Shiv Sena, because there is no better proof for that than an electoral result. I think inside the BJP camp, Poonam, I must tell you, there were apprehensions about how good Ajit Pawar will perform. Many people, in, even in the BJP, thought that Sharad Pawar, being the, you know, the expert he is and the old hand he is, maybe he'll be able to put up a good show. But the numbers do, you know, have even, I think, surprised the BJP with Ajit Pawar leading in as many as 37 seats. You know, that's also extremely high strike rate for him. That has also helped BJP put up a good performance in Western Maharashtra, Mahayuti, which was, you know, seen as a bit of a weak link for the BJP in these elections. So I think Ajit Pawar, for all the three constituents of the Mahayuti, have performed very well. And I was hearing a panelist earlier, in fact, saying that Mahayuti did not have coordination. You know, the numbers show how the Mahayuti partners have been able to transfer votes to each other. That is why such a huge verdict has come. On the other hand, on the Mahavikas Aghadi, the allies, both Congress, Uddhav Thackeray and Sharad Pawar, have miserably failed to transfer their votes to each other in an alliance. And that is why we see them at just 60 seats right now. I think the lot of introspection to do, especially for the Congress party, you know, which contested 102 seats and is just winning just 17 seats. It is bringing down the entire alliance. To quote the Prime Minister, the Parijivi party, which, you know, feeds on others and brings down the alliances.
And it's not just about getting the math right. There was rebellion within both camps as far as NDA and the Mahavikas Aghadi went. But the NDA and several of the BJP leaders were either placated or some of them were then given a ticket from the other camp. They contested or moved to the other party, contested on another ticket. And that's really what seems to have worked for the NDA in this case. More reactions coming in from on ground before I get in Yasha as well.
Sabha, because they know the efforts and work Dada has done in the taluka.
You know, there's a lot of one thing is going on. We met a lot of people in Baramati, also a lot of Baramati. This says that Dada should be, Ajit Dada should be made Chief Minister of Maharashtra. What is your feeling about this particular, you know, wishes from the voters, from the supporters?
Of course, even I feel the same way. But now, in regards to the results, all the you know, elder leaders will take that decision. But yeah, every Baramatikar does want to see Dada as the future Chief Minister.
Any words for the voters, you know, they give a huge victory to the voters.
Yeah, like I said, I would definitely want to take this opportunity to thank all the voters in entrusting the Mahayuti Sarkar with, you know, such a huge margin. And we will work for the progress of the state and the taluka.
Thank you so much.
Sanglas vatte, jasa mi tumhala sagyanla adipasa sangat aloe.
Pawar's son there also going on to build chorus for his father to be the chief minister. Well, Ajit Pawar's camp, Ajit Pawar has ensured that they pull the weight in the NDA. But the BJP is the single largest party with 132 seats at the last count, just to their own tally. You need 145 as a halfway mark, as majority in the assembly in Maharashtra, and 132 at last count are just with the BJP. Yasha, you were in Thane earlier today. Eknath Shinde's bastion, Gad, and that's really what the scenes were in Thane as well. Whereabouts are you now and what's the mood like?
So, you know, when you see, speak of the whole look and feel at Thane, in fact, even before we could leave from Thane, there were posters of our congratulating the Chief Minister for having secured this ovary. Leads. In fact, we cannot even say win because, of course, the results are still trickling in. But as of now, I am at Varsha Bungalow. We follow the Chief Minister all the way from Thane. He left this very official residence of his late last night and was at his actual residence at Thane so as to wait for the results to come in. Now that the results are out is where he is here. He showed the victory sign. He was present along with his grandson. I'll show you the kind of preparations that are on ground at the his residence. You know, in fact, the party karyakartas, the workers who were present right here, they had celebrations, distributed sweets. You know, here there is a rangoli that's being made by the karyakartas and the staff of Varsha, which says Abhinandan Sahib, which clearly means they're congratulating Chief Minister. Apart from that, you know, there's been celebrations that have taken place at the Varsha Bungalow. Karyakartas had gathered here. There were dholes, there was gulal, all of the celebrations that took place. And, you know, in a while from now, we'd expect both the deputy chief ministers to come in here and address a joint press conference. That is Ajit Pawar and Devendra Fadnavis would be here, following which we'd also see how Devendra Fadnavis would be heading to the BJP office. So, yes, you know, just before Eknath Shinde could come in, there was no celebration here. Those at Varsha Bungalow were waiting for that announcement to come in so that the celebrations could begin. As soon as Eknath Shinde was here, all celebrations have begun. In fact, Eknath Shinde, after having had the celebrations, has gone back inside. So now we'll have to wait for some more time to wait for that press conference. But the kind of figures that the Mahayuti has gotten has clearly had a joyous moment, because the numbers that had come in the exit poll did not have that kind of a clean sweep. But here, of course, this very result has outmarked all of it, and particularly all of those leaders in power have credited this to the schemes that that they implemented in the last couple of months. After the Lok Sabha election, we've seen the kind of rigorous work that all of the party workers or the party leaders had gotten into. In fact, in the run-up to the Vidhan Sabha election, it was also evident the kind of efforts that were put in by the Prime Minister, the Home Minister, and the senior leaders from the BJP. That's showing in 132 plus. In fact, until late last night, when we spoke to several party workers and party leaders, they hinted at 120 plus seats for BJP. But this is clearly, outshining the figures that even the BJP was expecting. And here, when it comes to Eknath Shinde, the kind of response that he's, that comes in from several MPs from the Shiv Sena shows that Eknath Shinde has clearly taken forward the legacy of Balasaheb Thackeray, because it
absolutely
was a prestige battle.
So that prestige battle has been won by Ajit Pawar and by Eknath Shinde both. So the legacy of the NCP and the Shiv Sena has been maintained by both these camps, and now they have a stamp of approval in terms of electoral wins to make that claim as well. Mayuresh joins us on this broadcast, but before I get you in, Mayuresh, let's listen into some more reactions pouring in from Maharashtra.
क्या आपकी पहली प्रतिक्रिया है? डीसीएम अजित पवार फिर एक बार काफी उभर कर आए हैं इस चुनाव में. राज्य भर में एनसीपी अजित पवार गुट को काफी बढ़िया जगह जो है वो भी मिली है विधानसभा के इस चुनाव में.
मैं तो पहले बारामती की जनता की मैं सब मतदारों की तहे दिल से मैं सबको धन्यवाद कहना चाहती हूँ. वो अजित दादा के साथ बहुत बहुत खंबीर से रहे हैं उनके साथ.
महायुति को भी जो मैंडेट मिला है पूरे राज्य भर में वो लैंडस्लाइड विक्ट्री की ओर जा रहा है. क्या आपकी अपेक्षा रहेगी अजित पवार मुख्यमंत्री बने? कई सारे होल्डिंग्स बारामती में देखे गए उस तरह के.
हर कोई कार्यकर्ता या जनता चाहती है कि अपना नेता बड़े बड़े पद पे जाए. वैसे बारामती की जनता हमेशा वो सोचती है, उनको चाहती है कि वो ऐसा बड़े पद पे जाए दादा, इसलिए उन्होंने सबने अपना अपना रखा है वो पोस्टर.
अच्छा, ये चुनाव जो रहा बारामती का, ये पहली बार चाचा और भतीजे के बीच में हुआ, इसके पहले ऐसे कभी नहीं हुआ था, जिसके वजह से पूरे देश भर में पवार की बारामती बाद में फिर शरद पवार की बनी, फिर अजित पवार की बनी, और फ्रैगमेंट्स हो गए इस चुनाव में पवार फैमिली में भी और पार्टी में भी. अब ये सारी चीजें जो है वो समेटने की कोई आशाएं आपको लगती है? ये पहले जैसा हो सकता है या चुनावी माहौल जिस तरह से रहा उसी तरह से अब पार्टियां भी अलग रहेगी और फैमिली भी?
अभी बारामती की जनता ने दिखा दिया है कि बारामती किसकी है. बस मुझे लगता है कि यही ट्रेंड अभी रहेगा.
What do you think was the difference that made to this election? Why did you get so many numbers?
I think it's the credit should go to none other than but Maharashtra CM Mr. Eknath Shinde, and he has worked really hard. His Ladki Banner scheme and the way he has carried the entire alliance together, worked hard for Mahayuti, not thinking about only Shiv Sena, but all the three parties. I think credit goes to him, no one else.
Robin, you've been part of the entire process, with the seat selection, etc. as well. What actually put you forward before anybody else? What would put you, forward before the other opposition parties? What kept you ahead?
I think Mahayuti was well ahead and prepared after Lok Sabha. We worked really hard to correct what went wrong. In terms of narrative, in terms of preparedness, in terms of seat selection, in terms of coordination, it was looking by far from our end that we are well ahead, we are well prepared, well organized, and opposition could not set a narrative.
You think there'll be smooth sailing from here on as well?
I don't think there should be an issue. I think there should be a smooth sailing next 5 years.
I know that you're not a voter of Maharashtra, neither are you a resident of Maharashtra, but who is your choice for the CM? Eknath Shinde, Devendra Fadnis, Ajit Pawar, everybody's party wants their leaders to become the CM. Who's your choice for the CM?
I'm not the right one to comment on that because my role is limited, but I hope that
Maharashtra wants a 24-hour active CM.
Yes.
Those reactions pouring in from Maharashtra. It's a saffron sweep as far as the state is concerned. Yasha, Mayuresh continue to be with us from on ground. Aman is with me here in the studio. Pallavi joining us as well. But Mayuresh, coming to you first, you're outside Ajit Pawar's residence. For the last 2 to 3 hours, we've seen several NCP leaders trickle into his residence. There's been a huddle of what's going to be next. Is the NCP camp also of the belief that all stakeholders will decide who the next CM is? Because supporters, of course, want Ajit Pawar to be the next CM.
No, NCP is quite clear regarding this stand, because they are saying that the numbers are, whatever the numbers they have got, they don't have that much number to stake claim on the CM post. And they are very much happy with their numbers, because right now somewhere around 39 to 40 seats they have got. We went inside, we met Ajit Pawar off camera, off record. He is right now sitting with all his party leaders, especially Praful Patel and Sunil Tatkar, and other party leaders are there. They are watching all the results live on the TV, and also they are taking stock of the situation from each and every constituency from where their candidates are contesting, and they are getting the, we can say, minute by minute or hour by hour report about the counting. So he is pretty much relaxed, and he clearly said, a one-liner, he said that, I want to thank all my sisters and the brothers who basically help us in this election, to win this election, and supported us massively. So that's a one-liner, we got it from him. But he also told that tomorrow there will be a CLP meeting of his party, in which they will choose the legislative party leader. And somewhere NCP is confident that either on 25th or 26th the swearing-in will happen, and the government the government formation will also happen. So it would be interesting to see that what portfolios this time Ajit Pawar gets, because this time he has got a very strong numbers with him.
Absolutely. And if he doesn't make a pitch for the CM or the deputy CM, he's definitely wanting a lion's share, because while many had called him dead weight after the Lok Sabha elections, Ajit Pawar has proven that he has pulled his weight in this alliance and ensured that it is a landslide victory for the NDA or the Mahayuti in Maharashtra. Pallavi joins us from on ground as well. Pallavi, whereabouts are you, and what's the mood like there?
Well, I mean, the mood, of course, within the Congress party is extremely low-key, and one can understand that. The Congress actually never believed, rather the Maharashtra Vikas Adari never actually believed that this would be a defeat for them. There was a hope within the MVA that, one, a sympathy factor for Uddhav Thackeray as well as for Sharad Pawar. Second, the Mahalakshmi scheme could give a takkar to the Larki Behen scheme. And also the fact that corruption, the farmers' woes in Vidarbha area, and also the fact that the Marathwada region, the Maratha reservation issues which resonated during the Lok Sabha, all of this will notch up figures for the MVA so that they can form a government. That clearly has not happened. We'll have to wait to see when the blame game begins, who blames who takes the responsibility, and whether they're going to start blaming the EVMs as well. But Poonam, this much I can tell you, that this is going to be seen as a huge setback, particularly to the Congress. After having lost in Haryana, also now losing in Maharashtra, despite the win or seeming win in Jharkhand, it's a victory which has been snatched from them. And for them, it's going to have a deep impact on the political strategy, one, of the Congress inside Parliament, and second, Rahul Gandhi's own standing as an LOP. I doubt if many of the players in the India bloc will now be ready to give the last and final word to Rahul Gandhi. That's one. Second, if Rahul was hoping that he's going to have those acrimonious attacks on the Prime Minister, whether it's on a Adani issue, whether it's on a Manipur issue, that sting may be out now. Third and finally, within the India bloc itself, the murmurs of dissent will begin. They already have. The Trinamool Congress, which has come up with a very good performance in West Bengal, is actually showing the mirror to the Congress party. The next election that we are heading for is in Delhi. And there, the AAP is a very important factor. And AAP and Congress are technically speaking allies of India bloc. Would AAP want to have an alliance? For now, the Delhi unit of the Congress party says no to it. But can the Congress party afford to go it alone? Can it shoulder the burden of yet another defeat in case it loses out in Delhi as well?
But would the Aam Aadmi Party want Congress with them? Many within the Aam Aadmi Party have already ruled out an alliance. And especially after today, they've too had a good performance as far as bipoles in Punjab are concerned. So as far as Delhi goes, Aman, the Aam Aadmi Party would not want to pull around what they may call Congress as a dead weight.
Absolutely, they will not. They have already ruled it out. Aam Aadmi Party would contest the election in Delhi on its own. Poonam, we should remember, in the last two assembly elections in Delhi, Congress has not been able to win a single seat. It scored a zero in the last two elections in Delhi. Congress voter base in Delhi is almost over. So I think AAP will take on directly on a contest with the BJP in Delhi. That said, what you were asking, actually, Mayuresh earlier and Yesha as well, the CM phase question, I think Poonam now will take precedence because such a big win has happened. Now the million-dollar question is, who will they choose as the chief minister? Because clearly, BJP with these kind of numbers, 133 seats, you know, it's itself just 11 short of the majority mark. So BJP with such a huge mandate, I think would want Devendra Fadnavis to be the chief minister because BJP cadre would want that. If you don't make Devendra Fadnavis the chief minister now, obviously the BJP cadre would say, what more do you want us to deliver to have our own chief minister? Also, the feeling in the Devendra Fadnavis, especially in Nagpur, the feeling was that in the 2022, what happened was a peculiar situation when the government was formed. Devendra Fadnavis, in line of the party's discipline, made a sacrifice and became the deputy chief minister. But now, with this kind of a mandate, Devendra Fadnavis should be back as the chief minister. And one must remember that in this election, the RSS has also been extremely active on the ground. Maybe the RSS will also have an important say in who becomes the chief minister. And we know that the closest person to the RSS in Maharashtra is Devendra Fadnavis.
And many would say, deservedly so, as far as Devendra Fadnavis goes, he's somebody who worked behind the scenes for a very long time, but ensured that work was being done on ground without getting into the limelight so much, without getting into getting pulled into all sorts of politics that was playing out in Maharashtra, and ensuring that the BJP and the NDA as a whole reached the number that they seem to be reaching at the moment. Aman continues to be with us, my colleagues from on ground, Mayuresh, Yesha and Pallavi also with us, but let's listen into some more reactions once again.
महाराष्ट्र में मतदाताओं ने जो भाजपा महायुति को जबरदस्त जीत दिलाई है, जो पायाभूत सुविधा होती है, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट होती है, वंदे भारत ट्रेन होती है, मेट्रो होती है, सड़क होती है, पानी होता है और प्रत्यक्ष लाभ में लाडली बहना होती है, किसान सम्मान होता है, जीरो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल का विषय होता है, इसका एक बहुत सुरेख मिलाप एकनाथ जी शिंदे, देवेंद्र जी और अजीत दादा ने किया और इसलिए जनता ने पूरा भरोसा रखा. साथ ही एकनाथ शिंदे जी, देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी, अजीत दादा पवार और भाजपा का केंद्रीय नेतृत्व साथ मिलकर इस विषय में निर्णय करेंगे और आपको बताएंगे. आज महायुति विजय का जश्न मना रही है.
मैं बस यही कहूंगी कि बड़े हैरान करने वाले नतीजे आए हैं. जिस तरीके से लोकसभा में 151 असेंबलीज पे हमारी लीड थी, वो सिमट कर अगर इस नंबर पे आ गई है, तो एक प्रश्न चिन्ह जरूर उठता है कि कैसे इतना डिफरेंस आ गया. जो भी सर्वेज चल रहे थे सब कांटे की टक्कर बता रहे थे. जो भी सर्वेज हो रहे थे उसमें महाविकास अगाड़ी को बढ़त दे रहे थे, सब बता रहे थे एज है. एक कांटे की टक्कर इस तरीके से हो जाना कहीं ना कहीं थोड़ा आश्चर्यजनक भी है, सवालों के घेरे में भी आता है और मन में मैं एक सेंस ऑफ सरप्राइज है कि जो हम जनता के बीच में देख रहे थे, महिलाओं के साथ देख रहे थे, पुरुषों के साथ देख रहे थे, आक्रोश जो था 1500 रुपए मिलने के बाद भी वो महिलाएं बता रही थी कि हम पे एहसान नहीं कर रहे जिस तरीके से प्रचार कर रहे हैं, और उसके बाद ये इस तरीके के आउटकम आना, आई वुड से हमें कुछ टाइम लगेगा फॉर इट टू सिंक इन.
थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा टू फॉर देयर रिजल्ट्स टू सिंक इन. दैट्स द यूबीटी सेना देयर. इफ यू लुक एट द टैली एट द बॉटम ऑफ योर स्क्रीन्स, दे आर परहैप्स द बेस्ट परफॉर्मर्स एज फार एज द इंडिया ब्लॉक गोज. माय कॉलीग्स कंटिन्यू टू बी विद अस ऑन दिस ब्रॉडकास्ट, गेटिंग अस मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड इनसाइड इन्फो एज फार एज द रंबलिंग्स इन महाराष्ट्र गो. व्हाट हैपेंस नेक्स्ट, हु इज गोइंग टू बी द नेक्स्ट चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ महाराष्ट्र इज अ क्वेश्चन द एवरीबडी इज आस्किंग, द आंसर टू विच इल्यूड्स एट लीस्ट एज ऑफ नाउ. Payal joining us, getting us more details as well. Payal, top leaders of the BJP are in a huddle is what we're given to understand.
Yes, Bhupendra Yadav has reached the residence of Devendra Fadnavis. Bhupendra Yadav is the election in charge as far as Maharashtra is concerned. Remember, he essentially had a lot of roles to play. This is his third election of Maharashtra. He's been somebody who's known the state and known the length and breadth. Was key responsibility was to manage the people who were naraz and make sure that there is no rebellion. Along with Piyush Goyal, senior minister in the government, and of course of Mumbai MP as well. So he's of course also been there at the residence.
Right, so the BJP in a huddle in a short while from now, we are going to be seeing a joint press briefing of Devendra Fadnavis, Ajit Pawar and Eknath Shinde. Some more details would perhaps come out then. But Payal, as far as the strategy of all of these camps go, what is it that Shinde camp believes worked in their favor. They are the second best performers as far as this election goes, with a strike rate of over 60%. Payal, I understand you're in the midst of all the action. We can hear the music and it must be very loud where you are. We'll try and reconnect that line. But Aman continues to be with us. But before that, some more reactions now coming in. Sanjay Raut of the UBT Sena reacting to the results, going on to point to the fact that this is not a result that is acceptable to us. Sanjay Raut calls for re-election on ballot papers this time around. So it's not just denying the mandate that you have, but it's also wanting a re-election. Is this just a case of sore losers, or is there more to that? Well, the NDA camp would say this is definitely just sore losers, not ready to accept the mandate of the people. Yasha joining us. Yasha, from EVMs being tampered with, EVM batteries having too much charge and not having too much charge, to now wanting re-election on ballot papers.
So, you know, this is a typical instance that we see that happens with the Mahavikas Aghadi and the India camp. When it comes to the elections, if it's in their favor, they've been supporting it, and if not, they've always said that it's the fault of the EVM or and which is why asking for a ballot paper. That's something that we've seen how it's time and again been questioned by the BJP as well, and here again. In fact, this morning also, when Sanjay Raut addressed this very issue, he spoke about the fact that this is a result that's not being acceptable to them. In fact, he also went ahead and said that it is that even the people of Maharashtra will not accept this result. But here we've heard several other leaders from the same party say it'll take them some time to accept that result. Here it is it's a typical instance of the left wing star just because they cannot get it. That's a typical request. That's a typical stand that is put forward by Sanjay Raut. In fact, when he spoke to several leaders from the Shiv Sena Eknath Shinde faction, they said that it was the statement that was being made by Sanjay Raut that was costing the UBT faction dearly, and which is why Sanjay Raut should stop making such statements. This is a stand that has been put forward by several leaders from the Mahayuti that Sanjay Raut should not take such stands. And here again, Sanjay Raut has gone ahead after questioning the whole election, after
right.
questioning the mandate of the people. He's gone ahead and said that there should be a ballot paper election. Now we have to wait to see what will be the reaction from the Mahayuti on this very
And even from the election commission to go on to respond to these kind of allegations, because they've done so multiple times in the past. The latest that we are getting to know right now is that Aditya Thackeray has won against Milind Deora from the Worli seat. Mayuresh joining us, getting us more details. Mayuresh, the counting is still on. The counting is over. As per the election commission, we're given to understand that there are two more rounds that are still on. But Aditya Thackeray does have a margin of over 9,000 votes.
Yeah, he does have a margin of 9,000 votes, and right now we have been given to understand that last few rounds are remaining, so that will take another half an hour to hour to get completed, unless Milind asks for recounting. So if he asks for the recounting and the matter is closed, then certainly the recounting will happen, and again we have to wait. But we are expecting to get the clear clarity on this particular results by, say, within half an hour, 45 minutes. But yes, Aditya Thackeray is having the margin of 9,000, and it would be interesting to see that after this next 2 to 3 rounds, how much margin he gets more.
Right, well, so far we're given to understand that Aditya Thackeray has emerged victorious as far as the Worli seat is concerned. As far as Mumbai goes, though, Mayuresh, we're given to understand that the BJP has managed to keep the lead as far as maximum city goes.
Absolutely, and it was kind of an unexpected result for everyone, because even pollsters during the exit polls also have shown a margin somewhere around a range of 150 to 180, but no one had thought that BJP alone will secure somewhere around 130 or 120, 130 seats. So it is unexpected result for everyone. And even when we spoke with Ajit Pawar a while back, off camera, off record, that time even he also said that it is kind of a surprising results we have got. And after a long time, it has been gone.
over 30 years, as far as if these numbers stick, if BJP does stick around at 131, then that's a party with that higher number after about 34 years, as per the calculations that we've made. If the number sticks around to 131, it was much higher sometime back. The counting is still underway in several seats, which is why you still see those numbers changing. In a few hours from now, of course, they will settle down, but at least two or three rounds of counting is underway in several of those 288 seats. More reactions trickling in from the state of Maharashtra. Let's listen in.
बहुत ही अपेक्षित था. महाराष्ट्र की जनता ने मोदी जी के नेतृत्व पर देश भर का जैसे विश्वास है ये वैसा ही दिया. विकास के राजनीति को वोट दिया क्योंकि महाराष्ट्र में 5 साल दो सरकारें देखे लोगों ने. 2.5 साल ब्लैक, 2.5 साल व्हाइट. 2.5 साल ब्लैक में कुछ सारे विकास काम नए हुए नहीं और सारे रोके गए. और अभी 2.5 साल में हर सेक्शन का वेलफेयर पॉलिटिक्स भी हुआ, वेलफेयर डेवलपमेंट का भी प्रोग्राम्स भी हुए और इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर और विकास के भी कार्यक्रम हुए. लोगों ने उसे पसंद किया और लोगों ने इसीलिए वोट दिए. मैं ऐसा मानता हूँ महाराष्ट्र का वोटर संकीर्णता से विचार नहीं करता, विकास के लिए वोट देता है और दिया है.
महायुति के पक्ष में मतलब जनता ने इतना भरभरून इतना बड़ा ज्यादा वोट दिया और मतलब हमें 200 के ऊपर मतलब सीटें मिल रही है तो ये हमारे लिए बहुत बड़ी जीत है. महाराष्ट्र की जनता का मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ. सभी जाति धर्म के लोगों का मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ और उन्होंने बहुत बड़ी जीत हमें दी है और उसका कारण यह है कि नरेंद्र मोदी जी की विकास की भूमिका और महाराष्ट्र सरकार ने 2.5 सालों में लिए हुए निर्णय और उसमें अनेक निर्णय तो अच्छे थे ही थे लेकिन लाडली बहना का निर्णय बहुत ही क्रांतिकारक था. हमें विश्वास है कि 225-230 तक सीटें हमको आगे तक मिल सकती है.
My colleagues continue to be with us, getting us updates and perspective. Aman, as far as the Vidarbha and Marathwada region is concerned, that was a concern, a worry for the BJP specifically and for the NDA, especially after the Lok Sabha elections. But they've seemed to have turned it around on its head in the last 6 months.
That clearly, I said, Vidarbha and Marathwada were the two regions where the BJP did not perform well at all in the Lok Sabha elections. There are 19 Lok Sabha seats here. BJP, the Mahayuti, could just win 3 of them. In fact, in Marathwada, BJP did not win any single seat. Only Shiv Sena, Shinde faction won the Aurangabad seat. So this time, a complete turnaround, not just the Maratha voter, but I think the farmers of Vidarbha have reposed their faith in the BJP. There are multiple reasons for this. You know, last time when the Lok Sabha elections happened, you know, there was a huge farmer distress. This year, the season has been better, what BJP leaders felt. Plus, Devendra Fadnavis' announcement in Wardha 2 months ago in September in the presence of the Prime Minister that the present cotton crop will be procured above the MSP. Second, the soya bean farmers also were under huge distress on the MSP issue. We saw in the manifesto and later also just before the votes were cast when the centre changed this scheme and said that up to 15% moisture soya bean will be procured at the MSP. I think all these factors together have worked for the BJP in Vidarbha and Marathwada also. I think has seen a lot of OBC consolidation for the BJP. Also, one point that, you know, the Ambedkarite Buddhist population, the Mahar population, which is there in big numbers in Vidarbha, in the last Lok Sabha election, there was a 3M kind of combination from the Mahavikas Agadi, Maratha, Muslim and Mahar. This time, I think the Mahar voter, which is the Buddhist Ambedkarite voter, seems to have seen through this hoax of the Mahavikas Agadi that the constitution will be changed, Samvidhan Khatre mein hai, reservations will go away. I think they seem to have returned to the BJP camp and I think the whole caste census pitch by Rahul Gandhi in Maharashtra, he did this Samvidhan Samman Sammelans in various cities, seems to have completely fallen flat. I think people did not believe that slogan anymore. People have gone with the Prime Minister's slogan of Ek hai to safe hai, which seems to have become the resounding verdict across the state with the BJP has got. And as we speak, BJP is at 132 leads. This is truly phenomenal. I think, Poonam, if you look at the numbers, this is the first time an alliance in Maharashtra has crossed 200 seats. This is the first time an alliance has over 50% vote share. I think there can't be... I think this is one of the biggest wins of the BJP in recent times.
And like I said, if the number sticks to 132 or anywhere above 130 for the BJP, then they would emerge as the single largest party with that high a number after about 34 years or so. The last time that happened was when Sharad Pawar was chief minister in the 90s. But Pallavi and Yasha also with us on this broadcast. Pallavi, if the numbers stay where they are at the moment, the Congress would not be able to claim even the leader of opposition's position in the state of Maharashtra.
And what a stark contrast to the fight that they were having yesterday, where they were actually fighting over who should become the chief minister. Congress from day one, under Nana Patole, who's a state Congress chief, and he's handpicked by Rahul Gandhi. And Nana Patole has been making this point from day one that, first of all, the Congress should get a lion's share as far as seat distribution is concerned, which they did. But a second important point that they're making is that, unlike last time round, where despite having the largest number of seats, they never got to have their own person as a chief minister, this time round, the CM will have to be from the Congress kitty. They were told to hold their horses, to calm down, and not to make these kind of public statements. And now to be reduced to a situation where the performance is much below mark, where there's a huge question mark over whether there will be a leader of opposition from the Congress party in the Maharashtra Assembly at all. It's a case of where most of the political strategy seems to have backfired, whether there was going to be a rework on it. Because in Haryana, one of the main reasons for the loss was a massive infighting, and that too many claimants as far as the CM was concerned. The situation seems to be the same. I'm not even talking about MVA generally, but to talk about Congress specifically, again, infighting. Again, that everyone, Balasaheb Thorat versus Nana Patole, Thorat has of course lost. These kind of fights which have worked within the Congress party has actually led to a complete breakdown of the Congress mechanism there. And of course, the fact that his caste censors and Samvidhan Khatre mein hai, against development projects in Dharavi, against the Adani, all of that certainly doesn't seem to have worked as far as Rahul Gandhi's poll plank is concerned.
Absolutely. It is going to be an uphill challenge for the Congress party as far as Delhi elections go. But they do have a win in their kitty as far as this election goes. Jharkhand at the moment seems to be going the JMM Congress's way. The numbers that you see on the left-hand side of your screens, 57 for the India bloc leads as far as Jharkhand is concerned. The NDA is at 23, a far second. Arunima joining us from Ranchi. Arunima, Hemant Soren, the chief minister, posting on social media after this imminent win. It's on expected lines for the Congress and JMM is what they believe.
Yes, the image that he tried to build of him being a family man, just as the tribal population of Jharkhand is. When the elections got over, he tweeted a picture of Kalpana Soren oiling his hair, his two pet dogs snuggling up to him, and another family member oiling Kalpana's hair, just to show that, like any other normal tribal family in Jharkhand, the chief minister also leads his daily life just like that, with his family. And today, after the win, Kalpana is in her constituency. She was facing a tough fight, initially trailing by about 4,000 votes. So you don't see her in that picture. But the two sons are there with Hemant. It's a very heartwarming picture, again, meant to convey the same image of Hemant Soren being a family man. He's converted this entire arrest that Enforcement Directorate carried out into a sympathy card for himself, convincing the voters successfully that he was targeted because he is a tribal and that the central government is anti-tribal. That narrative helped him in Lok Sabha. That narrative seemed to have sealed the deal for him here in the assembly elections also. The other thing that he's managed to encash upon is the women voters' sentiments. The Maiya Samman Yojana, 1,000 rupees in the bank account, promising to increase it to 2,500 after the election win. That also, it seems, has worked for him.
And that seems to have worked for the Congress in other states, which had prompted Aman, the BJP, to call this a Revdi system of trying to burden the state's coffers. But that's exactly what they did in Maharashtra as well. The allegation that they were making against the India bloc, or the Congress specifically, is a pattern they used and used successfully in Maharashtra.
Well, Poonam, if you see repeatedly last few elections, especially state elections, the experience has been that whichever government is the first mover when it comes to giving this money benefit to women always scores the goal. We have seen that in Madhya Pradesh when, you know, Shivraj Singh Chauhan, just before, in the last 6 months of his government, started this very Ladli Behen Yojana in Madhya Pradesh. We have seen BJP promise it in the state elections of Odisha as well as Chhattisgarh, and they stormed to power there. BJP retained power in Madhya Pradesh, and now Maharashtra is the recent example where, after the Lok Sabha elections debacle, the government decided to give money to women. They promised, you know, this money of 1,500 rupees to women, which BJP promised to take it to rupees 2,100 in their manifesto. Same seems to have worked in Jharkhand for the JMM government. They started it, though the criticism was that Hemant Soren started it too late, you know, too early towards the end of the election. He had promised it in the last election, but still, giving it the money in the hand of the woman voter. The woman voter, in my experience of covering elections, when it gets a money from a particular party, and you know, when it comes consistently over a few months, they develop trust in that party and they don't really fall for the promise of another party which is promising to give more, because they feel, okay, this money is for sure is going to come, you know, our home budget is decided from this now, but we don't are not sure if the other party is going to come and give this. And this is especially a problem, women voters I think have credibility with the Congress party, because Congress sometimes promises but doesn't give. But here it was the JMM, you know, who was promising this amount, and as Arunima was saying, this maybe has worked for Hemant Soren on the ground. People believed his round rupees 1,000 promise, and people also believed that the money he's promising to increase it to will also come if he comes back to power.
So that worked for the JMM Congress in Jharkhand. That seems to have worked for the NDA, along with several other factors that aided the 223 victory for the NDA at the moment. Those numbers, of course, could change. There could be a toss-up for at least a few seats, because counting is still underway in several of those seats. A few rounds are left in multiple seats across those states. Who is going to be the next Chief Minister of Maharashtra is the million-dollar question. The BJP is all but certain that Devendra Fadnavis is their man. Listen in to what the Vice President of the Maharashtra State BJP had to tell us.
जिस तरीके से यहाँ पर रिजल्ट आए हैं, कितनी कितनी बड़ी जीत मानते हैं इसको?
ये महायुति की प्रचंड जीत है। जिस तरीके से वोट जियाद के खिलाफ धर्मयुद्ध की बात की गई, इस धर्मयुद्ध की ये जीत है। लाड़की बहन की जीत है, किसानों की जीत है, कामगारों की जीत है, युवक और युवती की जीत है, कल्याणकारी योजनाओं की जीत है, और ये जीत भारतीय जनता पार्टी और महायुति की जीत है। ये जीत माननीय मोदी जी की जीत है, ये जीत देवेंद्र फडणवीस की जीत है, ये जीत एकनाथ शिंदे की जीत है।
बीजेपी की बहुत ज़्यादा सीटें आई हैं और ये अब मांग उठने लगी है कि बीजेपी का मुख्यमंत्री होना चाहिए।
कार्यकर्ता होने के नाते मुझे तो लगेगा कि मेरा नेता मुख्यमंत्री बने, तो मैं यही मांग करूंगा कि एकनाथ राव जी शिंदे दादा और देवेंद्र जी बैठे और माननीय अमित भाई और प्रधानमंत्री के साथ बैठकर भाजपा का मुख्यमंत्री चुने।
All stakeholders will sit down and take a final call of who the next chief minister is going to be. That's the sentiment that has come to the fore, at least on the face of it, from all three camps. But supporters making their pitch for their leader to be at the helm of affairs. Devendra Fadnavis is to be the CM is all but certain, many would say. Yasha, is that something that Eknath Shinde has also made peace with? Because I think they've all realized that if the numbers stay at 133, what the BJP has managed to do with that kind of a strike rate, the BJP and Devendra Fadnavis should deserve the seat of the Chief Minister.
Absolutely. See, you know, for an absolute majority, one requires 145 seats in Maharashtra. BJP alone seems to be close to 133. They are very close to 50% mark. They could, in fact, be forming the government by themselves. But here, of course, you know, when Eknath Shinde was asked this question, he said all of the parties would sit together and decide. But, you know, over the last several weeks, in the run-up to the Vidhan Sabha election, when this question was asked several times, so there was no direct indication, but time and again, be it Devendra Fadnavis or be it Amit Shah, they gave direct and indirect hints about Devendra Fadnavis becoming the chief ministerial face. However, one needs to wait and watch if Devendra Fadnavis will be made the CM, or to who the Maratha voters, Eknath Shinde, will continue as the CM yet again. There are several instances, in fact, 2.5 years back, when the government changed, everyone was looking at Devendra Fadnavis to be the chief minister then. But he made that sacrifice for the party and for the alliance in general, and accepted the post of deputy chief minister. Something that not everyone had expected that would happen to him. That was when Eknath Shinde was made the chief minister. But today, you know, of course, the credit for this win is being given to all of the three. Eknath Shinde and Devendra Fadnavis. Election after the performance of the Mahayuti Lok Sabha election.
On the upcoming Vidhan Sabha election. And however, that instance on has given to Amit Shah, you have to stay back and accept voter responsibilities. Now, when you think of this very instance, just a couple of things.
We'll try and reconnect that audio link with my colleague Yasha. She's outside Varsha Bungalow, which is the official residence of the Chief Minister in the state of Maharashtra. Eknath Shinde is currently there. Of course, celebrations breaking out. But Maharashtra is not the only state that we want to speak of. There were by-elections that were held across the country in different states. Uttar Pradesh was one of those states where it was a prestige battle. It was only a BJP versus a Samajwadi Party fight. Well, there were smaller parties like the BSP involved. But as far as the two big players were concerned, that was the Samajwadi Party and the BJP. Now, Pallavi, the Congress had bowed out of race because they could not reach consensus with the Samajwadi Party. It was decided that the Samajwadi Party would fight on all seats. Yogi Adityanath, the BJP, has managed to trump the Samajwadi Party as well in Uttar Pradesh. Another blow there coming to the fore for the India Alliance. Does this then give a leg up to the Congress perhaps to say that maybe the SP should have conceded some seats to us?
Well, I mean, I think the story is also not just Maharashtra and Jharkhand. I mean, there is also a big footnote coming in from the bipoll results. I mean, apart from West Bengal, which we have been speaking about, Uttar Pradesh becomes very, very significant. The Congress had opted out of the race, preferring not to divide any votes and give that edge to a Samajwadi Party. But here's the blow for them as well. Samvidhan khatre mein hai, the win by the Samajwadi Party in Faizabad helped the Congress and the Samajwadi Party, but more specifically Rahul Gandhi, to try and build up the narrative that a Ram Mandir politicization, Ram Mandir as Rahul Gandhi called it, had actually not helped the BJP. So they wanted to look at these bipoll results closely, hoping that there would be a redux of the Lok Sabha election moment, and whereby not contesting elections, the Samajwadi Party would have a clear edge over the BJP. That's clearly not been the case. Samajwadi Party, of course, has been extremely upset with the Congress because of no alliance happening, say, in Haryana, in Maharashtra, also pretty much on their own, so on and so forth. I think now what's going to also happen, and this is going to have an impact on the India bloc, the SP will say that the Congress has become a liability or a penalty for us. The Congress will hit back by saying, look, here we did not contest along with you. We never asked for any seats. Yet you did not manage to hold up on your own against the BJP. So why are you blaming the Congress party? Why should the India bloc stakeholders not even look at themselves and introspect?
So it'll be interesting to see how the dynamics plays out within the India bloc after this election. Aman, as far as the bipoles are concerned, Priyanka Gandhi has won on expected lines in Wayanad. She's also bettered Rahul Gandhi's margin as far as Wayanad goes. Karnataka, another story there, the NDA losing all three seats.
Yes, Wayanad was expected, Poonam, because this seat, anyways, Priyanka was expected to win, and now the brother-sister, both duo, will see them in Lok Sabha together. So that will be quite a sight to see the entire Gandhi family and Sonia Gandhi in the Rajya Sabha. So Wayanad win was expected. Yes, Karnataka is a big, big blow to the BJP. All three seats won by the Congress party, despite that, you know, the whole remark made about Kumaraswamy, still Channapatna scene had been won by the Congress party. So obviously that's a big blow, and the new BJP state chief Vijender would have a tough time, you know, explaining what has happened. There's already, I think, knives are out for him, for Vijender in Karnataka. Bengal also, I think BJP doesn't have good news. All bipoll seats have been lost to the TMC, so the RJ car issue doesn't seem to have really transcended into an electoral issue. But UP, yes. Uttar Pradesh, I think the 7 out of the 9 bipoll seats being won by Yogi Adityanath is a big, big morale booster for Yogi, especially after what happened in the Lok Sabha elections. BJP going ahead and winning these 7 seats except Karal, which is a Samajwadi Party stronghold, and another seat which SP has won. So I think Mr. Yogi Adityanath would take much, much comfort from this, and his slogan of batenge to katenge anyways becoming a big hit after the Haryana elections, working in Maharashtra as well, not working so much in Jharkhand. But yes, I think Yogi will be in more comfortable position with these 7 wins.
And it's interesting because in that campaign, he echoed the batenge to katenge comment every single rally. But now that he's taken to social media, tweeted and hailed the victory of the NDA in Maharashtra, he's reiterated a slogan that the Prime Minister coined, which many said was a positive spin to what Yogi Adityanath has said about ek hai to safe hai. Payal also joining us, getting us more perspective on this. Payal, we are of course awaiting that joint press briefing from Devendra Fadnavis, Eknath Shinde and Ajit Pawar. Would that give us a sense of who the next chief minister is going to be, or is that something that is going to still be happening inside closed doors, and we'll only find out when the swearing-in takes place, perhaps on the 25th or 26th of this month?
Well, it's likely to be on the 26th, is what we are given to understand, but it is going to be important to see what really comes out of this press conference. What will it take? The question both of them. This question will be who becomes the CM and when is the whole thing taking place. Very interesting, keeping in touch.
the bulldozers and the residents of the Chief Minister of Harsha over here. And I'll bring you another frame over here. My video journalist Ramadan is showing you a frame, which is the entrance at which Devendra Fadnavis and of course Ajit Pawar will be coming in a bit from now. They'll be welcomed here at this gate. But most important thing I need to show to our viewers is that, you know, of course, that is the short while ago on the window over there. You could see Ekta Shinde's young grandson, young child, watching what is happening from his group of up. He was probably just learning of the ropes from a very, very young age. He's been a lot of celebrity moves over here, but then he has two questions. What is the process that has to be followed before the teachers and naming these questions? Is there any party meeting that takes place?
Absolutely. So that press conference is going to take place in a few minutes from now. The celebrations have already broken out. The numbers are still hovering. A little toss-up happening here and there, but this is perhaps where it will eventually settle down at. 223 is what the NDA has at the moment. It could go a few seats up or down. But these visuals there coming in of BJP leaders, as we see, Devendra Fadnavis, Chandrakant Bavankule, the president of Maharashtra BJP. They were all together closely monitoring as early trends were coming in. Celebrations, a moment of joy, and deservedly so, as many would say. Amrita Fadnavis also spoke to us here on CNN News 18, the wife of Devendra Fadnavis. Listen in to what she has to say.
कैसा लग रहा है इतनी बड़ी जीत के बाद?
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है. महाराष्ट्र ने एक अपना वर्डिक्ट दिया है, कॉल दिया है, और बहुत खुशी हो रही है कि महायुति को इतना अच्छा प्रतिसाद मिला है लोगों से, और लोगों ने हमको सबको बीजेपी को महायुति को पसंद किया, और आज आप रिजल्ट देख ही रहे.
कभी लगा था इतनी लैंडस्लाइड विक्ट्री होगी?
प्रेडिक्शंस तो थे, और प्रेडिक्शंस हर टाइप के होते हैं, तो पॉजिटिव होना था, और एक्सपेक्टेशन से थोड़ा और अच्छा हुआ है, इसकी खुशी है.
हमने देखा था कि आप नागपुर में कैंपेन कर रही थी देवेंद्र जी के लिए, और खास करके विदर्भ में काफी क्लीन स्वीप मिला है बीजेपी को.
हाँ, बहुत खुशी है कि विदर्भ ने इतना, कि बहनों ने साथ दिया, हमारे बंधुओं ने साथ दिया, बहुत खुशी है इसकी, और सब उन्हीं की वजह से है जो रिजल्ट है, तो उन्हीं को सबसे बड़ा धन्यवाद, और हमारे कार्यकर्ताओं को.
तो क्या हम फिर से एक बार देवेंद्र जी को मुख्यमंत्री के तौर पर देखेंगे?
नहीं, मुझे उसकी कुछ आइडिया नहीं है. वो तो पार्टी तीनों में की, और मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट हमारे भाजपा के मुख्य नेता डिसाइड करेंगे, तो वी हैव टू वेट एंड वॉच.
तो आपको लगता है कि फिर से, क्योंकि नाम तो उन्हीं का चल रहा है,
हा नरेंद्र मोदी जींच्या पाठीशी आहे, आणि मोदी जींनी जो नारा दिला होता, एक है तो सेफ है, महाराष्ट्रातल्या सर्व समाजातल्या लोकांनी एकत्रित येऊन हा नारा यशस्वी केलेला आहे, सगळ्यांनी एकत्रित मतदान केलेला आहे, आणि विशेष आभार आमच्या लाडक्या बहिणींचे देखील आहेत की ज्यांनी आम्हाला खूप आशीर्वाद दिलेला आहे.
मिस्टर मोदी एक है तो सेफ है कॅम्पेन स्लोगन वर्कड फॉर अस, दॅट हॅज रेझोनेटेड विथ वोटर्स.
त्या फेक नरेटिव्हच्या विरोधात लढणाऱ्या ज्या वेगवेगळ्या संघटना आहेत राष्ट्रीय विचारांच्या,
this is a victory for all those who fought the fake narrative that was being spread by the Mahavikas Aghadi.
या महाराष्ट्रामध्ये महाविकास आघाडीने केला होता त्याच्या विरोधात लोकांमध्ये जनजागृती करणारे आमचे विविध पंथांचे जे संत आहेत त्यांचा देखील हा विजय आहे की ज्यांनी महाराष्ट्राला एक ठेवलाय, अशा सगळ्यांचा हा खऱ्या अर्थाने विजय आहे.
Religious leaders, seers and saints from across religions that worked on ground that ensured that the fake narrative that was being spread, the divide and rule policy that was being spread by the Mahavikas Aghadi did not work.
जे लाखो कार्यकर्ते आहेत या कार्यकर्त्यांचा विजय, माननीय मुख्यमंत्री एकनाथराव शिंदे जी, मी, अजित दादा, आमचे रामदास आठवले जी, आमचे सगळे मित्र पक्ष, आमच्या एकजुटीचा हा विजय आहे.
This is the victory of all three of us, of Eknath Shinde, of Ajit Pawar, their supporters, their leaders, and of the BJP. We fought elections unitedly. This is a united victory. I thank all our national leaders, including Nitin Gadkari, Rajnath Singh, JP Nadda, who all came to Maharashtra, boosted the morale of our cadre on ground, of gave us inspiration to fight this battle. Heartfelt thanks to all of them.
आम्ही नतमस्तक आहोत याच्यापेक्षा जास्त आज या ठिकाणी काही बोलताच येत नाही. अक्षरशः साष्टांग दंडवत महाराष्ट्राच्या जनतेला, ज्या महाराष्ट्राच्या जनतेने हे प्रेम दिलेलं आहे. आणि मला असं वाटतं की जो काही एक विषारी प्रचार सातत्याने झाला, त्या प्रचाराला महाराष्ट्राच्या जनतेने आपल्या कृतीतून उत्तर दिलेलं आहे.
The voters of Maharashtra through this result have shown those who tried to spread their poisonous campaign that will not work.
की आम्ही आधुनिक अभिमन्यू आहोत, आम्ही चक्रव्यूह तोडून दाखवू. तो चक्रव्यूह तुटलेला आहे आणि महाराष्ट्र मोदीजींच्या पाठीशी खंबीरपणे उभा
आहे. It's proven once again that Maharashtra is standing steadfastly behind Prime Minister Modi and is with his leadership.
महाराष्ट्र की जनता ने जो अप्रत्याशित इस प्रकार की जीत हमको दी है, इससे ये बात पूरी तरीके से स्थापित होती है कि महाराष्ट्र ये प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी के पीछे है. और मोदी जी ने जो नारा दिया था, एक है तो सेफ है, इस नारे को यथार्थ में लाते हुए महाराष्ट्र के सभी समाज के सभी लोगों ने एकता दिखाते हुए महाराष्ट्र में मतदान किया है और इसके कारण ये इतनी अच्छी जीत हमको मिली है. मैं विशेष रूप से हमारी लाडली बहनों का, लाडले भाइयों का, लाडले किसानों का, सभी का बहुत आभार व्यक्त करना चाहता हूँ. लाडली बहनों ने तो बहुत आशीर्वाद हमको दिया है, जिसके कारण हम लोग निश्चित रूप से एक अच्छा विजय यहाँ पर संपन्न कर पाए. इसके साथ साथ लोकसभा में जिस फेक नरेटिव को तैयार किया गया था और यहाँ पर जिन ताकतों ने अराजकता के माध्यम से फेक नरेटिव को परकोलेट किया था, उनके खिलाफ लड़ने वाली सारी जो राष्ट्रीय ताकतें थी, जो राष्ट्रवादी विचारों की जितनी हमारी ताकतें थी, वो सारी ताकतों ने मैदान में उतरकर उस फेक नरेटिव को समाप्त कर दिया. इसलिए उन सभी संगठनों का भी मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ जिन्होंने करके दिखाया. साथ साथ महाराष्ट्र में जो पोलराइजेशन का प्रयास किया गया था और किसी जाति विशेष, धर्म विशेष को, एक धर्म विशेष को पोलराइज करने का जो प्रयास किया गया था, मुझे लगता है वो प्रयास सफल नहीं हुआ, क्योंकि महाराष्ट्र में एक बहुत बड़ी परंपरा है, संतों की परंपरा है. इस परंपरा का निर्वाह करने वाले अलग अलग पंथों के जो हमारे सारे साधु संत है, उनका भी आशीर्वाद हमको मिला, जिन्होंने बिल्कुल गांव गांव तक जाकर अलख जगाया और एक रहने का संदेश दिया, जिसके कारण मैं ऐसा मानता हूं कि एक बहुत अच्छा विजय हमको मिला है. विशेष रूप से हमारे मुख्यमंत्री एकनाथ शिंदे जी, उप मुख्यमंत्री अजीत दादा पवार जी, रामदास अठावले जी और हमारे साथ की जितनी छोटी पार्टियां, हम सब लोग एक साथ रहे, एक साथ मिलकर हमने ये काम किया. इसलिए मैं ऐसा मानता हूँ कि इस एकता का यह विजय है. जो हमारी महायुति थी, अभेद्य इस प्रकार की महायुति थी, महायुति का यह विजय है, ऐसा मैं मानता हूँ. और साथ साथ मैं हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी का तो आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ, उनके कारण ही हमको ये जीत मिली है. लेकिन हमारे देश के गृह मंत्री श्री अमित शाह जी, जिन्होंने महाराष्ट्र में आकर कार्यकर्ताओं में एक ऊर्जा का संचार किया, मैं उनका भी आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ. हमारे राष्ट्रीय नेतृत्व हमारे नड्डा जी है, हमारे राजनाथ जी है, हमारे नितिन गडकरी जी है, इनका भी आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ. हमारे जो चुनाव के प्रभारी है, हमारे जो महाराष्ट्र से मंत्री है, इन सभी का मैं बहुत दिल से आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ कि पूरी पार्टी ताकत से हमारे साथ खड़ी हुई. और सबसे महत्व की बात है, हमारे नेताओं ने, हमारी पार्टी ने केवल बीजेपी की सीटों पर काम नहीं किया, हमारी पार्टी ने सारे के सारे महाराष्ट्र के जितने 288 सीटें थी हमारे दोस्तों की सीटों पर भी काम किया। और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इसके कारण एक बहुत अच्छा यहाँ कार्य संपन्न हुआ। हमारे भूपेंद्र यादव जी, अश्विनी वैष्णव जी, हमारे शिवप्रकाश जी, इनका भी मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। हमारे यहाँ पर जो हमारे सारे अलग अलग प्रांतों से भी जिन लोगों ने हमको मदद की उनका भी मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। हमारे पीयूष जी का मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ, हमारे शिवराज सिंह चौहान जी का भी मैं आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि एक प्रकार से सामूहिक रूप से हम लोग जब उतरे तो ये सामूहिक ताकत एक ऐसी ताकत बनी जिसने दिखा दिया कि महाराष्ट्र ये मोदी जी के ही साथ है। ऐसा है, मैंने पहले ही कहा था कि मैं आधुनिक अभिमन्यु हूँ, चक्रव्यूह को भेदना जानता हूँ, हमने चक्रव्यूह को भेदा है। और ये कोई मैं पहले भी कह रहा हूँ, वापस कह रहा हूँ, इस विजय में मेरा बहुत छोटा उसमें मैं समझता हूँ कि सहभाग है। एक ये हमारी जो पूरी टीम है, इस टीम ने इस विजय को लाया है। मला असं वाटतं की कुठल्याही लोकशाहीमध्ये एक चांगला विरोधी पक्ष असणं हे गरजेचं आहे। त्यामुळे जे काही विरोधी पक्षाचे लोक निवडून आलेले आहेत त्यांचा आम्ही सन्मान करू, त्यांचा आवाज छोटा असो की मोठा असो, ते ज्या योग्य गोष्टी सांगतील त्या योग्य गोष्टींवर आम्ही त्यांना प्रतिसाद देऊ।
डेमोक्रेसी, यू नीड ऑपोजिशन, वी विल गिव रिस्पेक्ट टू ऑल ऑफ द ऑपोजिशन एमएलएज हू हैव बीन इलेक्टेड इन दिस असेंबली।
आम्हाला ते माहितीच होतं, जर झारखंडमध्ये झारखंड मुक्ती मोर्चा जिंकला तर तिथलं ईव्हीएम टेम्पर प्रूफ परफेक्ट, एकदम जनमताचा कौल, लोकशाहीचा विजय। आणि महाराष्ट्रामध्ये हे धाराशाही झाल्याबरोबर लोकशाही खतऱ्यात आलेली आहे, ईव्हीएम प्रॉब्लेम मध्ये आहे, ईव्हीएम टेम्पर,
आर ईव्हीएम्स टेम्पर प्रूफ इन झारखंड वेअर द जेएमएम काँग्रेस हॅज वन अँड टेम्पर्ड विथ ओनली इन महाराष्ट्र वेअर द ऑपोजिशन कुडंट गेट अ मॅन्डेट।
सल्ला द्यायचा नाही आहे, मी थोडा बोलही नाही आहे, पण कधीतरी त्यांना खरी कारण काय आहे याचा विचार करावा।
आय डोंट वॉन्ट टू गिव्ह देम अडवाईस, बट द ओनली थिंग आय वॉन्ट टू टेल द ऑपोजिशन इज दॅट दे मस्ट इंट्रोस्पेक्ट ऑन व्हाय दिस हॅपन्स टू देम।
लोकशाहीची हीच खरी मला असं वाटतं गंमत आहे की लोकशाहीमध्ये कोणाला जनता डोक्यावर घेईल आणि कोणाला जनता धाराशाही करेल हे सांगता येत नाही।
In a democracy, the voter is supreme. Who they will give the mandate to and who they'll bring down is all up to them. That's the beauty of democracy, and this election has proven it once again.
या बाबतीत माननीय अमित भाई शहांनी प्रेस कॉन्फरन्स मध्ये क्लिअरली सांगितलेलं आहे, मुख्यमंत्री पद हे कुठल्या निकषावर नाही, मुख्यमंत्री पद तीनही पक्षाचे नेते एकत्रित बसून ठरवतील।
अमित शाह इन अ प्रेस कॉन्फरन्स हॅड मेड इट क्लिअर दॅट द डिसिजन ऑन द नेक्स्ट चीफ मिनिस्टर वुड बी टेकन बाय ऑल थ्री स्टेक होल्डर्स।
ते बसून जो निर्णय घेतील तो निर्णय असेल, कुठलाही वाद नाही आहे, कुठलाही विवाद नाही।
देयर इज नो डिसअग्रीमेंट ऑर आर्ग्युमेंट ओव्हर दॅट, व्हॉट एव्हर द आउटकम इज ऑफ अ मीटिंग बिटवीन ऑल थ्री स्टेक होल्डर्स दॅट वुड डिसाइड हु द नेक्स्ट चीफ मिनिस्टर इज।
सीएम पद के ऊपर कोई भी विवाद यहाँ नहीं होने वाला, क्योंकि पहले दिन से ये तय है कि चुनाव जब संपन्न होगा तो चुनाव के बाद तीनों पार्टियां मिलकर इसको तय करेगी। हमारे नेता आदरणीय होम मिनिस्टर साहब ने प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में ये बहुत स्पष्ट शब्दों में बताया है कि चुनाव के बाद तीनों पार्टियां बैठेगी और इसका निर्णय करेगी। अभी मैं ऐसा मानता हूं कि हमारे एकनाथ शिंदे जी उनके पार्टी के अध्यक्ष हैं, अजित पवार जी उनकी पार्टी के अध्यक्ष हैं, और साथ में हमारे पार्टी के जो राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष हैं उनको हमारा पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड ऑथोराइज करता है। तो ये लोग बैठ कर एक उचित निर्णय करेंगे, हमारे वरिष्ठ नेताओं से बातचीत करेंगे, हमारे पार्लियामेंट्री बोर्ड से बातचीत करेंगे, जो निर्णय होगा वो सबको मान्य होगा, इसमें कोई विवाद
नहीं।
बाबा आता पूर्ण रिझल्ट संपू द्या, आता आम्ही मी आणि अजित दादा आता सीएम साहेबांकडे चाललो आहे, आम्ही बसून जरा
I am headed towards the Chief Minister's residence. We'll let you know as soon as our next plans are finalized.
लोगों ने एकनाथ शिंदे जी को रियल शिवसेना के रूप में स्वीकार कर लिया है. बाला साहब ठाकरे के हिंदू हृदय सम्राट शिवसेना प्रमुख बाला साहब ठाकरे की जो शिवसेना है उसकी लेजिटिमसी ये एकनाथ शिंदे जी को मिली है और जो मूल एनसीपी है उसकी लेजिटिमसी अजित पवार जी को मिली.
पोलरायझेशन करण्याचा प्रयत्न महाविकास आघाडीकडनं आवर्जून केला गेला, विशेषतः मराठवाड्यामध्ये आणि विदर्भामध्ये पण वेगवेगळ्या ठिकाणी अशा स्वरूपाचा प्रचार केला गेला. तरी देखील विदर्भ आणि मराठवाडा याच्यामध्ये प्रचंड भाजपला यश मिळताना दिसतंय, याचं प्रमुख कॅरेन्सिस काय?
मला असं वाटतं की जेव्हा वारंवार तुम्ही एका व्यक्तीला एका पक्षाला टार्गेट करता त्यावेळी तुम्ही जे टार्गेट करता त्यातली हवा पण निघून जाते आणि त्याची तीव्रताही कमी होते आणि लोकांनाही त्याचं सत्य समजतं.
लोकांच्या मनात थिंक दे आर वेटिंग फॉर हिम टू फिनिश.
लोकांना लक्षात येतं की चुकीच्या पद्धतीनं टार्गेट केलं जातं. तसंच आम्हाला महाविकास आघाडीने ठरवून या ठिकाणी टार्गेट केलं पण मला असं वाटतं की हळूहळू लोकांनाही लक्षात आलं कारण आमचा ट्रॅक रेकॉर्ड चांगला. आम्ही नेहमी पॉझिटिव्ह काम केलेलं आहे त्यामुळे आमचा ट्रॅक रेकॉर्ड पाहून लोकांनी या ठिकाणी मतदान केलं. मला असं वाटतं की या निकालाने एक गोष्ट स्पष्ट केली आहे. हिंदू हृदय सम्राट शिवसेना प्रमुख बाळासाहेब ठाकरे यांची शिवसेना ही एकनाथराव शिंदेजींची शिवसेना आहे किंवा एकनाथराव शिंदेजी ज्या शिवसेनेचे प्रमुख आहेत तीच शिवसेना ही आता या ठिकाणी हिंदू हृदय सम्राट शिवसेना प्रमुख बाळासाहेब ठाकरेंची आहे. त्याची लेजिटिमसी जी आहे ती आता एकनाथराव शिंदेजींकडे आलेली आहे आणि तशीच राष्ट्रवादी काँग्रेसची लेजिटिमसी जनतेनं अजितदादा पवारांना दिलेली आहे. आईचा तर फक्त आशीर्वाद घेतला आहे, आईने आशीर्वाद दिला आहे आणि अमितभाईंनी खूप आनंद व्यक्त केला आणि अमितभाईंनी
in her blessings. And when Amit Shah called me, he expressed his happiness at the result that has come out. He congratulated me and every single BJP worker.
मैंने इससे पहले भी कहा था कि लोकसभा के चुनाव में हमको 43.6% मिले थे, उनको 43.9% मिले. तो अगर मराठा समाज ने हमको वोट नहीं दिया होता तो क्या हम 43.6% पर पहुंचते? मराठा समाज हमारे साथ था, है और रहेगा. ओबीसी समाज हमारे साथ था, है और रहेगा. सारे समाज आज आप जब इसको डिसाइफर करेंगे, जब आप इसका विश्लेषण करेंगे तो आपके ध्यान में आएगा कि सब समाज हमारे साथ में. देखिए हर समाज की अपनी इच्छाएँ होती है, आकांक्षाएँ होती है, लेकिन उनको ये भी पता होता है कि अपनी आकांक्षाएँ पूर्ण करने के लिए प्रामाणिकता से काम कौन कर सकता है. लोगों का विश्वास होता
है. 2019 मराठवाड्यात एक वर्षभर एक प्रेस झाली, त्यानंतर शरद पवारांनी ते लावलेला पैलवान हे वाक्य बोललं होतं आणि तुमचं आलेलं माइंडेड गव्हर्नमेंट पाडलं गेलं होतं कारणकारांनी, त्याचा प्रतिफळ बदला घेतला आहे का आत्ता आणि ते लावलेला पैलवान?
कुठलाही बदला मी घेतलेला नाही. राजकारणामध्ये जनता ठरवते कोण जिंकेल कोण हरेल. कधी कधी एखाद्या गोष्टीचा नापसंती जनता कळवते, त्यामुळे यातनं जनतेने कदाचित नापसंती कळवली असेल आणि आमच्या बाबतीत पसंती कळवली असेल. मला असं वाटतं की याला वेगळ्या पद्धतीनं पाहण्याचं कारण नाही आणि नंबर्स काय आहे याच्या आधारावर मी विरोधी पक्षाचं मूल्यमापन करणार.
सर, चाणक्य नीतीवरून जी चर्चा सुरू झालेली आहे, महाराष्ट्र चाणक्य म्हणून शरद पवारांचा उल्लेख वारंवार केला जायचा, आता महाराष्ट्र चाणक्य बदल आहे?
बदललं असेल तर मला माहीत नाही, फक्त मी एवढंच सांगू शकतो की मी तरी चाणक्य वगैरे काही नाही. मी भारतीय जनता पक्षाचा साधा कार्यकर्ता आहे. माझा पक्ष मला ताकद देतो, माझ्या पाठीशी उभा राहतो, म्हणून मला हे सगळं करता येतं. आमच्या पक्षातले
चाणक्य आहेत. If that's what people are calling me, the party stands by me and that's where I gather my strength from. I work for the party and the party helps me do what I do.
जनता पक्षाचा हा विजय आहे, याच्यात देवेंद्र फडणवीसचं कॉन्ट्रीब्युशन हे
Fadnavis'
contribution to this victory is not significant. It is a victory of the entire party, of the entire workforce and the cadre of the BJP.
पहली बात तो ये है कि संजय राउत इनके ऊपर मैं कोई प्रतिक्रिया देता नहीं, लेकिन आज आवश्यकता इसलिए दे रहा हूँ। मुझे ये पता है कि झारखंड में झारखंड मुक्ति मोर्चा जीता है तो बहुत लेजिटिमेट जीता है, वहाँ चुनाव एकदम फेयर हुआ है, वहाँ पर इलेक्शन कमीशन ने अच्छा काम किया है, वहाँ पर EVM इतना पक्का था कि वो हैक ही नहीं हो सकता, वहाँ लोकतंत्र का विजय हुआ है। और महाराष्ट्र में अगर हमको लैंडस्लाइड विक्ट्री मिली है तो इलेक्शन कमीशन भी बायस हो गया है, यहाँ का EVM हैक हो गया है, यहाँ पर लोकतंत्र की हत्या हो गई है। ये कभी ना कभी आत्मचिंतन करने की आवश्यकता होती है, जो आत्मचिंतन नहीं करते जिंदगी में वो समाप्त हो जाता है। मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि कभी ना कभी आत्मचिंतन करना चाहिए, और इस प्रकार से वो बात करेंगे तो क्या लोगों का विश्वास बैठेगा? चलो थैंक यू।
राजकारणामध्ये कोणीच कोणाला संपवू शकत नाही, जनता तुम्हाला कमी अधिक करते, त्याच्यामुळे मी आहे आणि ते आहे।
Thereafter, its triumphant victory in Maharashtra in tow with Devendra Fadnavis was state BJP president. The BJP's Maharashtra in charge, Bhupendra Yadav. Piyush Goyal, member of parliament from Mumbai, also in the background there.
समंदर 2022 में वापिस आ गया, क्योंकि हम सब लोग मिलकर यहाँ पर सरकार स्थापन करने वाले हैं, इसलिए मुझे लगता है कि कोई इसमें बहुत शेरो शायरी करने की आवश्यकता नहीं है। मैं एक गोष्ट मला या निमित्ताने सांगायची आहे, जी निश्चितपणे सांगितली पाहिजे, की आमचे अध्यक्ष चंद्रशेखर बावनकुळे यांच्या नेतृत्वात गेल्या 2 वर्षात पार्टीने खालपर्यंत जे कार्यक्रम राबवले त्यामुळे पूर्ण पार्टी जिवंत झाली आणि पार्टीच्या कार्यकर्त्यांनी ही निवडणूक अंगावर घेतली, आणि म्हणून मी बावनकुळेजी आणि आमच्या पार्टीच्या कार्यकर्त्यांचे मनापासून आभार मानतो। मैं हमारे अध्यक्ष चंद्रशेखर बावनकुळेजी और पार्टी के सभी कार्यकर्ताओं का आभार व्यक्त करना चाहता हूँ। इन कार्यकर्ताओं ने हमारे बावनकुळेजी के नेतृत्व में पिछले 2 साल लगातार नीचे तक जाकर पार्टी को प्रस्तापित किया, पार्टी के कार्यक्रम उन्होंने वहाँ पर संपन्न किए, और उसके कारण पार्टी में एक नई जान
आई।
It was the BJP there after its landslide victory. At last count, the numbers for the BJP are at 133. Counting is still underway in several of those seats. For several of them, they're just leads and not wins just yet. The numbers could be a toss-up, a few up or a few down. But essentially, it is a victory for the NDA. They're way past the halfway mark as far as the 288-seat strong assembly in Maharashtra is concerned. Celebrations have begun at all camps in the NDA.